That lady is such an inspiration that she's been able to overcome such adversity. What an inspiration. Thanks for playing that, you guys.
It's a great film, isn't
it? You know, sometimes we take things for granted. Quite a bit of it. We take things for granted. Our health. Just the fact that we can sit here and talk.
Yeah.
We can't do that with locked-in syndrome. They just keep they blink. So...
Well, speaking of health, you're looking good, Donny.
Why, thank you.
Raring to go, fighting fit for your brand new tour.
Absolutely.
Because you're back on the road, aren't you?
Now, before we talk about that, I gotta tell you something. Okay, I've been looking forward to doing the show. I did this show 5 years ago, right? I tweeted about this a couple hours ago.
Yes, we saw it.
You saw it?
Yeah,
you did. Matt, did you see it?
No, you didn't. No.
And this is what I said. Looking forward to being on the One Show with at Miss Alex Jones and Matt Baker. We go live at 7 p.m. at BBC One Show. What's Matt's Twitter handle? This is what I got back. From Maggie, Mag the Nag.
This is
a massive advert for
Matt.
Yes.
Doesn't have a Twitter account anymore. Maybe you can persuade him to open a new one. He's an idiot. I put the idiot part in there. Matt, hold on. It's 2012. You don't have a Twitter account?
Well, I like to talk to people face to face.
Now, Donny, we've got about 2 minutes to talk about your tour, so let's go. Now,
we're opening up at the O2 at January 20th, I believe is the date. And it's the first time Marie and I have performed together here in London in a long time.
Right.
We're bringing our Vegas show and a whole lot more to the O2 and then all across the UK. And I can hardly wait, man. This is going to be such an exciting show.
Well, there's definitely a buzz. People are so excited.
They are. Is it kind of a scaled-down version of what we're seeing here? Because over there, I mean, you just won, what, Best Performer, Best Singer, beating Celine Dion?
Oh, we did, yeah. It was awarded the best show in Vegas for 2012. So, no, what we're bringing here is not a scaled-down version. It's an upscale version.
Oh, it's an up, really?
Oh, yeah.
Wow, so this is going to be spectacular.
Yeah, I mean, we're bringing the lot.
And with the Vegas show, you did it for 4 years, a residency of 4 years, 6 shows a week. How do you manage it then? How do you cope? Where does the stamina come from?
I have no idea, Alex. I mean, when you see the show, you wonder. I wonder how I get through every night. I mean, just dripping wet with sweat because all the dancing and all the singing. It's a very difficult show.
Yeah.
We don't get up there and just sing a bunch of songs in front of a microphone. Marie and I, we really leave it all on the stage.
And I mean, obviously, you've been doing this since an incredibly young age. I mean, has your kind of your inspiration and your energy changed, and yet the reason why you're doing it, has that changed a lot throughout your life?
My outlook on this business has changed, you know.
Yeah.
At first, I was this little 5-year-old kid having a good time, you know, just getting up there and singing the song. I had no idea how many people were watching me on television. And then when I did Puppy Love and all that, I had no idea how many thousands of girls were just buying the records. And I loved the screaming, and that was great work. And then reinventing myself and coming back later on. Now, it's all about just picking and choosing the fun things, because I'm celebrating 50 years in the business.
Nice.
And it's not like, I don't want to keep climbing that ladder just to climb a ladder. I want to do things because they're fun. This show at the O2 and all across the UK, we're going to do this because it's going to be so much fun.
Yeah.
You know, I work hard at what I do, but I love it.
But it's great that you and Marie are back together, but is there a chance that the whole family will come together at some point again?
No.
Why do you say that?
Well, a lot of them can't perform anymore. So the 2008 tour that we did here, that was the final tour. We're not like Cher, we don't announce our final tour every year. that was the last one where everybody's going to perform on stage.
Yeah. Well, speaking of family, though, you've just become a grandfather for the fourth time? We saw that on Twitter, too.
Yeah?
Yes.
See, Matt doesn't know this stuff.
I was thinking, I'm
Matt doesn't know it. He's not connected. Get with it, Matt.
No.
Follow me. Get an account and follow me. Okay. That's an order.
Donny, like you just said, I've been there and I've done that, I suppose. But now, what kind of grandfather are you then?
I guess I'm a fun grandfather. I mean, I just act like one of the kids. My wife and I have this funny saying. We've had 5 children, but she's raised 6 because I act such a kid around the house. So I guess it's hard for me to say that I'm a grandpa. I mean, I act like I'm in my 20s on stage. I'm running around like crazy, dancing like crazy. So I don't know.
And interestingly, you didn't kind of push your children in the way that your dad pushed you guys.
Well, I won't say my dad pushed me. You know, when I was 12, 13 years old, I made a conscious effort, this is what I want to do. You know, up until that point, yes, get in the rehearsal hall. Yes, dance in front of those mirrors. Yes, make it better. But at that young age, I decided, this is what I want to do the rest of my life.
Incredible that you can make the decision at that age.
Now you've got thousands of girls screaming after you. It's an easy decision.
Right. I mean,
nothing's changed there, Donny. I mean, my family have come from Wales to see you. We've got people outside that have come to see you. So the appeal is still there. There they are.
Look. Oh, there they are.
You know, I've got some of the most loyal fans. They've been with me for such a long time.
Yeah. They were out there, for, honestly, straight after lunch today. That was earlier on, obviously.
Look, but the demographics have changed so much.
Yeah.
Younger kids are starting to realize who I am. When I won Dancing with the Stars, which is your Strictly Come Dancing, I won this. This little kid came to Vegas to see us perform. And we have a meet and greet after the show.
Right.
And he's in the queue waiting to meet me, and his excitement is just growing and growing. And he walks up to me because he wants to shake the champion's hand. I grab his hand, he looks up at me, and he says, Mr. Osmond, I didn't know you could sing, too.
And you can see Donny and Marie on tour in the UK from January.
Okay, now moving on to another group who defined the 70s. The Rolling Stones are up there with the Olympics and having one of the most recognisable logos around.
So how did one of the world's biggest bands become one of the world's biggest brands?
Well, Cary Grant has the story behind these luscious lips.
Look no further than the top of lips.
I'm sorry. That story was not accurate.
And why?
The way they came up with that logo with the tongue, like he's throwing up, they were listening to a Marie Osmond album.
I'm not
there.
Why do? Behave yourself.
Talking of Donny Marie.
Either that or Donny Osmond album.
This is you.
Look at all this.
This is original merchandise from the 70s.
You know, I got to tell you, some of this stuff I never knew existed. Somebody got really rich off of us.
There's a Donny puppet here.
I know, it's awesome. This is great. It's like little sort of karaoke.
A karaoke machine, yeah.
Yeah. Did you have an idea, you know, like what you say, you didn't realise a lot of this stuff existed. Did any of it sort of go through you as a family to say, yes, we like that, we don't like that, like dolls' faces and all of that?
Nope. Somebody made a lot of money off the Osmond brand.
Really?
You know, they just pumped the market full of stuff. It wasn't until eBay came out that I realised how much stuff was really out there. So then I realized, there was a ton of stuff.
And when you see, what do you feel about it? I mean, do you have any of this stuff at home? Would you like to put it in the loft?
It's okay now. I mean, there was a time in my life where I kind of cringed because it was damaging, in my opinion, damaging the brand because everybody was just like throwing merchandise out there.
But your grandchildren would love that mini drum set, look.
I don't think so, baby.
But saying that, Donny, I mean, talking of damaging the brand in the late 80s, even Michael Jackson turned around to you and he said that your name is poison.
That's right. Michael did say, because I asked him, I said, Mike, this is when Thriller was coming out, and I said, Mike, how do I get back on the charts? Because at one point in time, it was Donny and Michael, and then he left me in the dust, went to superstardom. I said, how do you do it? He said, change your name. And he was actually kind of right in a way, because when I came out with Soldier of Love, it came out under a white label. Nobody knew it was me. And it wasn't a marketing ploy. The radio stations just didn't want to admit that they were playing Donny Osmond music because the brand was so, goody-goody, tarnished, whatever. So I had to reinvent myself and come up with something brand new. They called it the comeback of the 80s.
Right.
With the Soldier of Love.
And you've kind of gone back to that, you know, that crisp, nice, you know, safe brand as you are now.
Well, I am who I am. And I don't really profess to be anything else. You know, you call me whatever you want to, but I'm enjoying my life. I enjoy my career now. There were times where it was a little rocky.
Yeah.
But I love what I do, and I've been here 50 years,
and
the tour that's coming up, I can hardly wait to launch this tour because it's going to be so much fun. A lot of work, but it's a lot of fun.
Can't wait till January, Donny.
Yeah.
Now then, before we go, we wanted to remind you that at 8 o'clock this evening on BBC One, you can see our One Show Award handed out at the first ever BBC 999.
Now, our award celebrates members of the public's quick thinking in an emergency situation, and it's part of a larger celebration of the emergency servicemen and women who risk their lives for us every single day.
Yes, well, there we are, so make sure you watch a date.
Yeah.
Donny, thank you so much. Good luck.
And Matt's going to get a Twitter account and follow me.
I'm going to watch it.
Donny, earlier on we promised you a little bit more of the closing
song. Oh, I got it.
Here are the Urban Voices Collective with a song that they performed last Sunday, Because...